Hey everybody, welcome to eTrailer.com. I'm Bobby, and today we're taking a look at the Kuat Sherpa 2.0 here in the back of our 2016 BMW X3. Now guys, this can be a very nice way of giving yourself small, little, medium-sized carrier that's going to do an excellent job of getting your bikes to wherever your destination might take you. Now the Kuat Sherpa, of course, very, very stylish. You can see what today we are working on the gunmetal gray. We have some copper orange accents throughout it as well, which of course makes it very, very sleek. Not only are we dealing with style though, we still have a lot of capability with it. We are having a 40-pound capacity per bike, which means we should have no trouble getting most of our standard and even a lot of those mountain bikes up on this bad boy with no trouble. One thing it's excellent for too, carbon frame bikes. You guys can see we have a simple front wheel holder here doing all the work of keeping our bike nice and secure on the back of our carrier. So that's going to be excellent because we don't have any frame contacts. They're not going to be damaging our carbon frames as we get them on there. And a lot of times too, when you start dealing with frame mounted options, you have issues with your bars working. So women's bikes, step-through bikes, kids' bikes, we're going to completely negate all that headache of having to worry about bike adapter bars and all that nonsense. All we need is one good wheel in the front to go ahead and start securing our bike. Now we are going to have a back strip here too, holding onto our rear wheel. The strips themselves have a nice little plastic matting on the inside just to prevent any kind of damage to our wheel rims as they're sitting on there. And we do have this back cradle as well, which I like. You guys can see it oscillates here. Has that 18C standard groove in it though. Widened out, it's about 3 inches or so, allowing ourselves to get most of the bikes we need up on here. Now I will say, fat back tires, not gonna be great here. As you can see, this strip, just not quite long enough. And as you guys can see, kind of a smaller platform itself and cradle throughout the entirety of this piece. So not really designed for your big, heavy, bulky bikes, especially with only that 40-pound capacity. Now, if you're talking about, man, I kind of want it to be 60 or so, I got some heavier bikes, I might not be just bringing my carbon frame bikes along with me, I highly recommend taking a look at the Kuat Envy. It is going to give you a couple other features with it as well. However, the big thing with it, it's going to be a little bigger, going to be a little wider, going to allow you to carry those 60-pound bikes with no trouble at all with a 60-pound per bike rating. Can be excellent if you're just needing a little bit more oomph. However, I think the Sherpa delivers exactly what you want it for if your bikes are well within that range. One thing I like about it, not as wide, a little bit more compact, and just looks really sleek, especially on our nice BMW here, which itself isn't too bulky. So I think it fits pretty good for ourselves if it's fitting within your bike's capabilities. One awesome thing about this as well, guys, we actually can tilt this away while our bike is still on it. And I think that's one of the big takeaways from platform style racks. This is one of the huge advantage, and you love to see it when they actually can do it. So all we gotta do, come right up to this lever right here, pull that guy towards me, allow myself to tilt down, having our bike hang off, and then I can come right out to my hatch and simply open it like so. Now you guys can see here, I got about a whole hand spacing between my handlebars here today, but if you had very long handlebars, that might be something to look at. However, that's always going to be an issue with any carrier out there. And since we're not passing really close to it, I don't think it's going to be causing us any issues. But as you guys can see now, I can get in here, walk up, get my coolers, bike helmets, anything I might need. Becomes a great little spot too to go ahead and change your shoes. You can use the carrier itself to give you a nice little lean on it, which is great. That way we don't have any issues, of course, getting our shoes on. We can get in the back there with no trouble. So also, if you have this on here, what's nice too, kind of a little advantage over the hanging style. Yes, you can open your hatches with those. However, can't really do it with the bike on it. So this becomes a great little way of keeping your bike still secure to your carrier, not having to take them off every time. Gas stops, groceries, anything like that. Becomes really easy to utilize. To walk it up though, I just simply support my mast. Walk it up until I hear that click, and we know we are nice and secure there. No pins or clips to have to worry about. It is all just right there, ready to go. Now talking about right there, ready to go, we have this little guy right here on the inside of our first set on our platform. That's gonna go ahead and allow us to utilize that locking core and the included cable lock to run through both of our bikes right into that position there and lock itself in. Now that will be key-to-like to the hitch lock that we have on our carrier as well. So that way you only have to have one key to make sure that you can get to all of your locks, which if you're a little like me, it does come with that spare. Nice that we have that extra one just in case we misplace the other. And that's just really nice that it's right here on the end. Sometimes you start seeing them being put on the inside or on the back, and that becomes a real pain, especially when you take your bike off quickly. You're having to reach through both of your bikes. It just becomes a hassle. So I like it that it's on the outside platform. Very, very easy to access. Well, it's not gonna take me too long to actually get this bike off. To do so, I'm just gonna come right up to this back strip here and simply pull it out. Of course, that lever just lets it ratchet out while it goes down. Now, one last little thing before I take the bike off, let's go ahead and see exactly how it's interacting here. You can see our wheels are gonna be pretty much right aligned here with our taillights. So one thing to look out for, You are going to have just a little bit of lock there. However, especially since we're not having any like fat bike tires, I don't think we're going to have too much issue with it. The only thing being, you are going to have just a little bit of visibility kind of hindrance, but nice that we have this spacing out here so our emittance of our light is still going to be seen. When we hit that brake, you're still going to get a lot of red. People are going to know we're going to stop. So not going to be the end of the world for us, of course. But to go ahead and take this off, completing ourselves, we just want to go ahead and make sure we're holding onto our bike. We don't want that tilting, falling in the vehicle or ourselves to cause any damage. So we can just simply press in on our lever, walk it right up, out to the side, and walk this guy off real easy. So, of course, the carbon frame bike, way lighter than others to walk it up on there. But even with a 40-pound bike, I don't think we're going to have any issue of getting up on there for ourselves. To bring our arms in doesn't take any time at all. We just simply bring it up, bring in that arm. You can even go ahead and put in that strip for ourselves. And one last little thing too is going to be this front wheel holder. So you guys kind of noticed we talked about this oscillating wheel right here. So our maximum wheelbase is going to be about 47 inches. So one thing that's nice about it, even if you are kind of exceeding that just a little bit, you actually can have your bike hanging off just a little bit. Now, of course, if you're completely falling off, I definitely want to be having this on here. However, if you're like, man, it's hanging on there, but it's just kind of in a rough spot, one thing that's nice about this, this does act as a wheel chalk. So you can see this is going to do a great job of giving you some backing on that front wheel. So as we cinch it down, it will be nice and secure, yes, but it also won't be falling off on the back end, which I do love to see. Well, in this position, we are going to be worried about our clearance since we are just semi-close to the ground here, and we are a little bit extended from that rear axle. Let's go ahead and see exactly what kind of clearance we're working with here today. From the ground to the very end of our carrier, which our arm is actually going to be our furthest point, we can go ahead and see from the ground to the very end of our carrier now is putting us at about an eighth inches there from the ground to the very end. So I think we're in a pretty good spot. A foot and a half usually is doing pretty good. However, the BMW does sit a little low. Let's just keep in mind, as those front wheels go up, the back will go down, and so will your hitch-mounted accessory. So if you find yourself tackling some steep terrain, could be a slight issue, or if you're off-roading in your BMW, which I don't see most of us doing. However, let's just be a little conscious that we do have some clearance to look out for. Now, one other dimension we do want to keep in mind is how much length we're adding to our BMW X3. Now, not the longest vehicle out there, not the shortest, of course. Well, let's go ahead and see exactly what we're working with. From the rear of our bumper here, go ahead, and it looks like our furthest point is going to be right at that position there. To the very end of our carrier is going to be putting us right over 32 inches, so about 32 and one quarter inches from the back of our vehicle. Definitely not too much length being added here. Keep in mind, you're only on a two bike platform, so it's quite a little bit shorter than most, and we do have a way of quickly shortening that down. We're going to come right back to that lever we utilized earlier right here in the middle, and instead of tilting down, I'm going to go ahead and tilt it right back up and lock it in position. One thing I like about the Sherpa as well, you can see, locks right in there. You're going to have a slight little movement, but nothing that's going to be terrible. You're not going to be feeling it. It's not going to be making contact with your vehicle. And talking about contact with the vehicle, you might be worried, well, are these arms going to be walking into my vehicle all the time? Well, no, they have a very good resistance. It takes me quite a lot, and at the very top of the lever too, as you guys can see, to get enough force to actually get that close. So with your normal jostle and movement on the back of your vehicle as you drive, don't think we're going to have any issue. Just to give you guys that quick little measurement, though, for yourself, looks like our closest point here today is going to be right here on the inside. And judging from the bottom here, kind of a hard angle, there we go. I can go ahead and say I'm right under 5 inches, about 4 3/4 inches as our closest point to our carrier. And of course, our farthest point of our carrier from our vehicle now that we've gone ahead and shaved it down is going to be about 14 and a half inches right there to the end of our anti-rattle. So now hopefully we can pull this in the garage with no trouble, but it's going to give you a lot more maneuverability when you want to park this guy at the trailhead or wherever you might be. So nice that we can quickly fold that up and have no trouble. Moving our way to the inside though, here you can see we do have a 2-inch shank here today utilized by our 2-inch hitch, and that's going to go ahead and allow us to use also throw in our alignment pin. So this guy isn't really doing too much. A lot of times you start seeing threaded anti-rattle bolts, but we actually have a different device. However, we actually do have a little locking core on that alignment pin as well. As we mentioned earlier, that will be key to like, and that's going to make it really easy to make sure your carrier stays attached to your vehicle when you leave it unattended. Moving our way to the outside though, here you can actually see where all our anti-rattle measures coming from. This is going to be your little anti-rattle knob. Now, I really like these guys. You have this little steel cam in the middle of your receiver, and all we have to do is tighten this up, and it's going to tighten this to our hitch, bringing it online to one system. And as you guys can see here in a second, as I go to shake this guy, it's shaking the entirety of the BMW. It is kind of a tank right there, not wanting to move on me. But that means we're all in line with one system, making for a nicer, smoother ride for ourselves, our bike rack, especially our bikes as they sit on there, which is excellent. And one last little thing I really like about that anti-rattle as well, guys, it does have an insert allowing you to really tighten that down, especially if you find yourself going for some long road trips. Nice that we can go ahead, really cinch that, and that way we're not checking it every 50 miles or so. Well, again, guys, the Sherpa can be a great little pickup if you're just finding something for that medium capability of getting you to your destination. Again, highly recommend taking a look at that Kuat Envy if you're looking for that 60-pound capacity rating. And if you're not quite liking this color, it also does come in black and pearl, not only the gunmetal gray. So you go ahead and match that to your vehicle as well. One thing I really like about it, too, the Sherpa's not too high in this folded position. Your backup camera is still going to get pretty good coverage here. Now, you're probably going to lose a little bit on that southern half, of course, just as you guys go through it, because we are kind of right in the way. But nice that we're still going to be getting that whole view around us with no trouble for ourselves. Well, guys, I think that about does it for our look at the Kuat Sherpa 2.0 here in our 2016 BMW X3. I'm Bobby. Thank you for watching.
Here on our test course, we'll start by going through the slalom. This is going to show us the side-to-side action, which simulates turning corners or evasive maneuvers. Once we get to the alternating speed bumps, we'll see the twisting action. This will simulate hitting a curb or a pothole or driving over uneven pavement. Now lastly, we're going over some full speed bumps, and we can see here the up and down action. And this will just be like driving in and out of a parking lot, garage, or driveway. So we can see here how the bike rack moves with our truck.